transforming emotional crisis, relational crisis. Big one. Transforming relational emotional crisis. You know, at the moment, all around me, it seems almost everyone I know is experiencing this. Perhaps it's something in the stars. And, you know, I'm interested in how we can harvest some of this crisis energy and use it for our higher evolution in some way. And this is the great question of this series. Of like, how can we transform these shadow aspects? So think about crisis, you know, and most of the time it's emotional crisis, it's relationship crisis. But you could also apply it to planetary crisis and, you know, at just about anything. You know, crisis is kind of like a tornado or a whirling, you know, whirlwind, you know, and we look at it and we can see it coming or feel it coming, and it's sort of this gray, black, kind of wild energy that just looks like it's terrifying. And what is going to happen when that hits me? And, you know, that the terror that we feel as humans about that, because we're going to lose control and, you know, who knows what will become of us. And so, you know, and you may be in the middle of one of those right now, or you may be at the beginning of one, and, you know, you may not know what's going on and how to handle it. And that's totally understandable and human. So I want to just look at it like, what if this were a magical crisis? You know, what if this were a magical crisis? You know, and you could look at that same whirlwind that's coming at you, or even that you're inside of, and instead of seeing it as made up of kind of dark colors, you could see it as multicolored, multidimensional, infinite colors of light, just rainbows flinging themselves around in different shapes and configurations, you know, colors that just you've never even seen before. And every current and every wind and whirlwind in that crisis, it's an opportunity. It's something that can sweeten your life even more. It's something that can be magical, you know, if you follow it and if you trust it and if you allow it to transform you. So instead of, so you've got this rainbow whirlwind ahead of you or around you, and you're like, wow, which current shall I trust to take me on a journey? Instead of like the terror, you could be like, whoa, I wonder what this is going to lead to. And so you surrender into that current and you see what teaching comes through you. And it's just, if you can just even look at your crisis in this way, just even like with a little bit of distance, look at it in this new way. It's a magical crisis, you know, and there are potential new births that could come out of this that could be extraordinary, not just for you, but for all concerned, you know. And this is a way I want to invite you to look at such a time, such an event as it overtakes us. You know, that we can surrender into the currents and begin to harvest like some of their, you know, their fragrances and juices, and we can learn from them and expand our consciousness and expand our capacity to love and forgive and all of that. You know, it's like a new way of looking at, you know, crisis as a whole. We can do it for the whole planet. We can do it for the crisis that the Earth is currently in. You know, and our species, like imagine what a new species would look like on the other side of this. You know, if we were able to surrender like the dervish into the spin, and we could just totally trust it and learn from it and emerge, re-emerge on the other side, reborn. You know, this is the way to attend a crisis. And if a crisis is coming towards you right now, or you're in the middle of the maelstrom, then you're being prepared, perhaps, for the sake of the whole of humanity, you know, so that how you handle this crisis may dictate how humanity handles a bigger crisis that's coming for all of us, you know. So crisis does not have to be an enemy. The other thing I wanted to say here is that, you know, we can transform crisis into compassion. You know, and this is what I've begun to suggest. But what do I mean by compassion? Usually, when there's an emotional relational crisis. The greatest learning is about personal boundaries. You know, this is the greatest learning. And I have a dear mentor of mine who said to me once, you know, that the greatest art that a human can learn is the art of returning non-love with love. And I've thought about that for many, many years, and I've even made it a part of my teaching and something that I attempt to live by. And it has layers and layers to it. I've realized over the years it's not just a simple thing like returning non-love with love. It's actually a gauntlet thrown down to humanity and to myself that you can pick up and test yourself with. And for me, one of the things I've learned is that, you know, sometimes returning non-love with love, you know, because in one sense, I know that there's no such thing as non-love, okay? But that we know what I mean. It's like, you know, someone that comes at you with an energy that is destructive, let's say, and how are you going to return that? Now, if you return that with just like, oh, loving, open, yes, come and get, you know, submission, that's not what it means. You know, it doesn't mean surrender. It might mean surrender. You could try that route and see where it leads you. But more often than not, it means self-love first, right? So returning it with love can be like, well, how do I love myself in this situation? How can I be gentler to myself in this situation? And then you return that non-love with a boundary. Yeah, and that boundary might come out as no. It might come out as F you. You know, it might come out as a really firm boundary, you know, that's really clear for you. And that's your form of self-love for yourself, you know, and also to break the pattern with the other. You know, and so, you know, part of the process of love can be, especially in relationships where there's a crisis, it's almost always, you know, having to stand up for yourself, not in an angry way, in a firm, gentle way, you know, gentle and firm, like you with a child. Like, so you can be courteous, but you can be very firm, you know, and, you know, and that's what's needed often, you know, and so returning non-love with love is not just about being nice. You know, it's way more than that. There's a lot more nuance to it. And that's what it's what compassion really is. Compassion is the appropriate form of love, you know, to the occasion. You know, and that requires skillful means, what the Buddhists call skillful means, to know what is the appropriate form of love. You know, what is the Aikido I can do here? You know, and that so I can return, if it's a forceful, destructive energy, I can return it back to them, you know, with that boundary saying, you know, and it might come back to them with quite a lot of force. You know, it might come, you know, it might go back with that equal force, but without the rage or the anger or the personal nature. It's just like, I'm not receiving that. I'm not playing that game with you. You know, I'm separating myself out from this pattern and pulling away from you. And it's about that pulling away and that complete clean energy that's often needed in times of crisis in relationships. You pull away from the other. You have to cut off. You know, often, you know, an ending is not done cleanly. And you can save yourself and the other a lot of pain by doing it, by ending it cleanly and quickly. You know, and that doesn't mean you have to end it. It just means you might have to kind of end it temporarily even and just to give yourself the space so that you can heal your own heart again and come back to yourself. And then you can see, well, is there enough respect and friendship left here to rebuild again? Or have we gone past that? You know, and the heart and the soul always knows that. You know, it always knows that deep inside. And so if there's enough respect and love left, you can rebuild, but you have to do that cut often so that you have the clear boundary, so that you can take care of yourself and your heart and your soul, rather than being caught in this constant, you know, cycle of pain and reaction. And that's what compassion really is. Compassion is learning how to say yes and no in the right way and at the right time. And it can be a beautiful learning. As I said, that's the beauty of the multicolored crisis, is that you can learn so much self-respect and self-esteem. You can really rebuild your self-esteem through a crisis. I mean, it's an extraordinary thing to stand up for yourself. Like, wow, I never really did that. I never stood up to that energy before. And I finally have, you know, I've said no, enough, you know, and I've moved in myself through that self-love, and that has changed me and allowed me to move and be open to something completely new, a new pattern. So, transforming crisis, magical crisis, into compassion. I wish you all the best with that one. And I know how widespread this is, and I hope that this is of help to you, this contemplation. Blessings.